In the last part of this tutorial, we focus on personnel costs in some more detail. The reason is that staff costs account for a large share of the project's total costs, more than 60% on average. When you check the personnel costs, your assessment should cover three elements: the number of person months requested, the level of qualifications requested, and the personnel costs per month, meaning the monthly rates included in the budget. For the last point, to help you judge the costs per month, we provide a personnel cost dashboard. It shows the average costs for personnel funded by Horizon Europe grants. The link to the dashboard is in the expert briefing slides. You can also scan the QR code displayed at the end of this video to go to the dashboard directly. When you get to the dashboard, make sure you read the instructions on the landing page. On the dashboard, select the country and organization type of the applicant whose budget you are looking at. This is important because personnel costs vary greatly between countries and different types of organizations. Check if the personnel costs per month included in the lump sum budget table are reasonable compared with the distribution of personnel costs in the dashboard. Very high personnel costs should receive special attention. Be aware that the dashboard shows personnel costs from previously signed grants. By default, only the newest data are displayed. This means data from Horizon Europe. In most cases, these data should be sufficient. If not, you can add older data from Horizon 2020 by selecting Horizon 2020 from the drop-down menu. Considering pay rises during the last few years, you can expect the personnel costs in a new proposal to be somewhat higher than in the dashboard. You should accept a moderate increase due to inflation. You should also take into account that the dashboard shows average personnel costs across all staff categories. This means that monthly rates for highly qualified or senior staff might well be above the dashboard values. Let's look at a concrete example: the personnel cost of a French small and medium enterprise. We see that the monthly rate for junior staff is well within the distribution on the dashboard, so this is okay. The monthly rate for senior staff is above the distribution. This is also acceptable because the rate is not much above the dashboard values. It should just be clear from the proposal that the senior staff included in the budget is actually needed for the project. In contrast, personnel costs that are way above the dashboard values should not be accepted. Such high rates may only be accepted exceptionally if they are very well justified. Otherwise, they must be reduced. For example, a monthly rate that is twice as high as the 80th percentile cannot be accepted unless it is justified by exceptional circumstances. In the absence of clear justification, the rate must be reduced, and the reduction should be recorded in your report as a recommendation to modify the budget. In general, very high rates should be reduced to bring them down to a value that is within the distribution shown on the dashboard, or just above. The value you recommend depends on the type of staff needed and the justification that the applicants may have provided. Do not worry that this exercise will only produce an approximate result. We cannot expect a precise figure here. What is important is that you identify excessive costs and bring them down to a reasonable level. In summary, you should pay particular attention to high personnel costs. Monthly rates that clearly exceed the dashboard values should normally be reduced. However, you should not automatically reject monthly personnel costs only because they are higher than the dashboard values. Monthly rates above the 80th percentile may well be acceptable, but should be explained by the proposal. They can be justified, for example, by the need for senior staff or by inflation. If you consider that the proposed personnel costs are too high, check if the applicants justify them before you decide on a reduction. The justification should normally be in the comments tab of the budget table. To wrap up, we can say that lump sum proposals are evaluated in much the same way as all other proposals in Horizon Europe. You apply the standard criteria, and as usual, you put your comments for each criterion in the individual evaluation report. The assessment of the lump sum budget table is an additional task. If you think the budget needs to be modified, include your recommendations under the implementation criteria. You can find more information on how to evaluate lump sum proposals in the expert briefing slides and on the landing page of the lump sum dashboard.